Classroom. This is Birinder. This is kind of the second session I'm attending since you released your book. And in my mind, I was thinking, should I do a second one because I already attended one? But this was great because you spoke about so many different things. During Diwali, I generally do like a gifting, and I do gifting of books, and I gifted your book to a lot of my friends, and they kind of loved it. So it was really nice.
Did you buy them and gift them? Or
of course. And there's no other way, right?
Yeah, okay.
There's no other way. A question on just a little follow-up on the education. When we think about post-graduation and courses which are professional, a lot of people are thinking, saying, okay, I'm going to do this course, can this add value to my employability? And since you said you had done a lot of research around every business of yours, did you do research around saying, okay, if a person taking an online course, is it going to add, will an employer really look at it differently, or is the market ready to look at people who've taken online courses?
Yeah, so we started this whole idea. I found my co-founder actually in only March of this, of 2015. And by June, we had made a deadline that we were going to launch our first course on November 25th. And it was just one of those things. After some stage, you just say, and that's, I think, is not sitting on the fence. So during those 4 months, we did an incredible amount of research. If you wanted to do a course on big data, which I think today is like, you can do an MBA in big data, because I think that's next. So we identified, where will there be employability of more than 300,000 postgraduate students over a period of time? What are the sectors that will open up employment above 300,000 people? We focused on those, and we came up with 15 different courses as far as that is concerned. Then we met everyone in that sector and said, what would you like people to learn? And I can tell you, we're working in the rural sector, and I know we did a tie-up there with HSBC for skill development. And we were with the Minister of Skill Development, Rudy, and he was talking about, and I said, in India, skill development, we feel, is that we educate people on a skill, whatever that may be, it's plumbing, or it's electrical, or it's housekeeping, or it's being an air hostess or a purser. I don't think we groom ourselves for the challenges of a job. So the soft skills, we completely miss out on. And I can tell you that the first 60 people we groomed in our rural India with INFS, it was a complete disaster. It was a huge learning for us, because we sent 14 of them to Maruti in Delhi. And 4 days they ran away. Because of the simple reason that it was a different culture for them, and I think we had failed to teach them the culture that for the first time you're getting into a job, what does it mean to understand a job and whatever else. So absolutely we did an incredible amount of research on each of the sectors. Again, we started with this course on entrepreneurship, and then now we have 500 people who've taken it, we paid 50,000 rupees each. And our business target was 50 people, because we didn't think that many more. And for the first 4 months, everyone said, yeah, but can entrepreneurship be taught? And my simple answer was, yeah, maybe not. But in this 3 months, I'm going to get a lot of people who are sitting on the fence to get a lot more clear about their own self. And two, if I can tell you that you can save about 20 of the 100 mistakes you're going to make in the first 2 years by attending this course, it's going to be paisa vasool. So those are the different criteria.
Thank you.